And I'm going to go ahead and just go into the Word of God and take some time to pray with you over this coming year and to disconnect us from some things from the previous year. In Isaiah chapter 40, verse 31, it says the following. But those who trust in the New King James Version, it says, those who wait upon the Lord will renew their strength. They will soar with wings like eagles. They will run and not get weary, and they will walk and not faint. If you go to Psalm 103, verse 5, it says the following. Is that God, He fills my life with good things, and my youth is renewed like the eagles. Somebody say amen. In the scriptures, we see that God's invisible attributes means His characteristics are seen in the things that God has created. Just like you can look at a painting and say that there is a painter, you can look at the building and say there is a builder, you look at the creation and you say there is a creator. But not only the creation proves that there is a creator, but creation carries a resemblance of the creator. The creation meaning you and I, creation means the nature, and creation means the animal kingdom. And one of the characteristics that portrays or reveals God is a lion, who is the king of the jungle. And another one that God connects Himself to is an eagle, which is like the king of all the bird kingdom and all of the air. Eagles have been emblems and symbols of strength and courage for centuries, and even nations have used them as an emblem to represent courage, fearlessness and strength and power, fierceness and even majesty. Having an eagle or seeing an eagle is a really great sight to see. This evening, for the few moments that we have today, I'm not here to talk about birds. You did that in school, and you probably, a lot of things we learn in school are completely pointless. A lot. Very good things that we learned there, and we have teachers here who are putting their head down as a sign of warning that I'm drowning the ship. But the reality is, a lot of things in school that you learn, they don't really apply. The same thing happens in the church. A lot of times, a lot of things that are spoken, they're very good, but they have no connection to us. My goal is not to teach you about eagles today. My goal is to take an eagle as an example, and through that we can bring a ministry to us and to serve you, and that the Holy Spirit will be able to touch your life and bring your life from a certain situation that you are in. Amen. Few things I want you to write down that will concern from eagle, but it will apply into our life, and we will go straight into application in this place. One of them is eagles, they mate for life. They have a very interesting policy. When they date for marriage, and when they marry, they have marriage for dating, and they stick with one spouse, and with that one spouse, they raise their children, and then they don't cheat on one another, and actually they stick with male, female. There is no that kind of a thing that there's going on today in our culture, and it's not with eagles, and it's an example to us that it shouldn't be with us. First of all, those of you who are single today, I want to give you a reminder, and I want to give you a direction for those of you who are not ready to be married. If you go into dating without intent of being married, it's like going into and going shopping without money. You will end up either with something that you've stolen or with something that you're not happy with. This coming year, you have to make a decision. If you're in high school, if you're in that age that you are not ready for marriage, you are not ready for dating. Dating is for people who are preparing for marriage. Dating is not for people who are bored on Friday night and who need to feel their emotional itch and scratch that. When eagles, they do that courting period, it's only for that time where they will be mating and eventually starting a family. And same thing has to happen in your life if you want to succeed. One of the biggest things that can ruin your life is dating for sake of fun. If you want to do something fun, install Netflix, get a dog, mow the lawn, come for morning prayer, get a bicycle, ride a transit, go running, get a Gold's Gym membership. You know, get a Starbucks card and go to Starbucks every day. But you must understand, you cannot go horse riding. Learn to drive a car. Learn to drive, fly a plane. But you cannot date somebody for fun because it involves somebody's soul and your soul is attached and it creates complexities eventually in your future. Amen? What eagles do when a female eagle finds a male eagle, and how she begins to decide whether he is ready for her or whether he is good for her, is she plays this game. Now, not the games that most girls play today. She plays a game, but this is a different game. She picks a branch and she flies really high and she lets eagle chase her, and as she flies really high, she drops the branch and she wants to see whether the eagle will keep chasing her or chase the branch. When the eagle chases the branch, picks up the branch and catches up with her again, she snatches that branch from him and flies a little bit lower and drops the branch and continues this up to 6 or 8 times until she is as low as 500 feet, where the branch potentially can fall really fast and the eagle will not be able to catch the branch before it hits the ground. If the eagle fails the test and does not catch the branch but continues to pursue her, or allows the branch to fall on the ground, the female eagle will chase him away and will never let him to be a mate for life. Because she is more interested in someone being able to pick up things than to chase her. Even eagles with a very small IQ compared to you know that in relationships, commitment is always more important than chemistry. When you are a young person approaching a next year, a lot of you will be married. A lot of you are in that season where you're beginning to look for someone. What do you look for? In the world, you look for chemistry. Means you look for somebody who gives you goosebumps. You look for somebody who makes you to skip a heartbeat. You look for that. Somebody who chases you and pursues you. But as kingdom of God, as children of God, our main priority is chemistry is very good. But the commitment this person carries is as important as the chemistry you feel for them. Because if you don't have the commitment, that chemistry will not last very long. If they cannot pick up their budget, if they cannot pick up their clothes, if they cannot clean up their habits, if their life is a mess, but they are madly in love with you, they can't keep a job for 2 weeks, but they love you so much, run from that like you would run from the devil. Drop him like a hot potato. Drop him like a bad habit or her, run from it. The charm won't last very long. Commitment is what's important. If the person watches a football game and on Sunday can't make it to church because there's football, well, now you know where his God is, in front of a TV. If a person says, you know what, hey, I can't come to church because there's something else going on, I can't tithe because, you know, I have this habit on the side, there you know where their commitments are. And you have to choose a person not based on their weight, not based on their shape, not based on their culture. You have to choose the person, first of all, based on their level of commitment. Can they be committed to God? Because if they're not committed to God, they won't be committed to you. They won't be committed to the family. They'll make you pregnant and run at the side of your stomach getting bigger, realizing you have a child. This happens all the time. And God wants to bless you with the person who will be committed. But in order to do that, God has to make you the person who is committed. Because it will be unfair for them if you are not committed. So the goal today is I'm going to be a committed person and God is going to bless me with a committed person in Jesus' name. Amen. If you are a single person, the goal today is that next year, if you're not planning to get married next year, it's not your time to date. It's your time to see God. Save money, pay off debt, get in shape and start a home group. Perfect. You have a vision for 2016. I want you to rise to your feet. I want you to rise to your feet. Actually, only the singles. All the single people, I want you to rise to your feet. All the married people, you have arrived, you have achieved. the rest of us. If you are not married, I want you to arise to your feet, please. Don't worry, you're not in trouble and you have not committed unpardonable sin. I want us to take a moment right now. As we are approaching next year, how many of you saying next year, don't raise your hand, but you're saying next year, you know, it's not my time to get married. I want you to pray right now that God will give you a purity and righteousness to live holy. Don't remember, God can bring somebody into your life and bless it if you don't live holy. But if you are today, you're saying, you know what, I feel like this is my year. Especially I'm praying for single moms. I'm praying for dads or people who already maybe have been in a relationship before, even those maybe who walked out of a divorce, that next year or years to come, that God is going to bless you with the relationship in Jesus' name. And this relationship won't be like the other one, but this relationship will give you blessing, but you will be a blessing in Jesus' name. I want you to close your eyes, lift your hands to heaven right now, and we're going to pray together. Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, we ask you right now, Holy Spirit, that you're going to begin to move mightily, that this coming year, God, that you're going to do awesome and great things in the life of every single person. Father, we pray right now for all the single moms. We pray right now, Father, also for people who have walked out of a divorce, who may be carrying a scar, that you will begin to heal and restore. Father, I pray right now in the name of Jesus for all the single people, God, who just graduated high school or who are in high school, that you're just gonna bring them that freedom, God, from not living like the world, but to live holy and to live righteous. God, to commit their life, Father, not to live according to the standards of our society, but to live according to the standards of your word, and to live holy and to live healthy and to live satisfied and to live fulfilled by the presence and the power of Most High God. We bless every single person. I bless, Father, that next year we're going to see many people married, but not married like people in the world, but married your way. I bless, God, that you will begin to just supply each one of them, God, with your purpose and your direction. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. And everybody said, amen, amen, amen. I want you to keep the microphone on. The number two about eagles that I want you to keep in mind is that eagles can fly without flapping their wings. A lot of birds cannot fly without their wings flapping. Most birds, when they fly, they have to flap their wings. We can't fly. Even if you sing that you believe that you can fly, you still can't fly. But eagles can fly, and most of them, most of the time, will fly, and you will see a picture of an eagle with its wings spread like an airplane and not flapping at all and just flying. Some of them can fly up to 150 miles per hour. Some eagles were found on the same height as the airplane, 10,000 miles. What is the secret of flying without flapping? An eagle's wings are so heavy and so long that if an eagle will flap its wings all the time, it will exhaust its energy, will become so weary that actually it can die in a flight. One of the ways eagle preserves his energy is to wait for a gust of wind to come. And then when a special wind comes in, it just literally goes on that wind, and that wind begins to carry that eagle into a higher altitudes without an eagle flapping. But what the only reason that wind is doing that is because the eagle is spread its wings. This coming year and the years to come, you must understand life has storms, and life sometimes has crazy days. As a Christian, as a believer, you have something within you that no one else has. It's called your wings. Your wings is your faith. It's in the moment of challenging situations, you actually can spread your faith before God. And you can allow that challenging situation that causes the turkeys and the chickens and the vultures to run and hide. But for you, you can spread your wings in faith before God, and that problem can actually elevate you higher in your career, in your family, in your finances, in your life and even in your relationship. Instead of breaking that relationship with your spouse, it will bring it closer. Instead of driving those kids away, it could bring them closer. Instead of causing you to be a school dropout, it can bring you, your faith can bring you closer where you actually begin to succeed in those subjects and you graduate with 4.0. Instead of quitting college because your tuition ran out, when you spread your faith, God begins to give you scholarship provision and you recognize you finished college and not only finished it, but finished it without debt. It's Goliath who promoted David. It was Goliath who made David famous. And it was the lions who gave promotion to Daniel. Because when he got thrown to the lions, afterward the Bible says, and he got promoted. It's the fire kindled 7 times that took the 3 Hebrew boys who were just normal people in the government. And after that, they got promoted and a letter was written. Anyone who says a bad word about their God, their house will be destroyed. How could problems kill some people and promote others? Because people who are like eagles, and that is you and that is me, instead of sitting there and hiding, you got the wings that they have. You have the wings they had. It's just sometimes our challenge is that we don't spread them. Everyone has a measure of faith. But this year, instead of asking and wishing and hoping you have bigger faith, use the faith you have and you will see what God will do. Spread the faith that you got before God and you will see what God will do in your dead marriage, maybe in your dried up finances, maybe in your challenging financial situation, maybe in your emotional bankruptcy. If in that moment you say, God, I'm not gonna flap and try harder, I'm gonna trust more, and you will see me through. Can somebody say amen? I have a gentleman in my home group who just recently gave his life to Jesus Christ and had his second DUI. Because of that, he was supposed to have his license be taken away. There was no way, there were some other things that were there, there was no way he could have not had his license taken away. He says, if my license will be taken away, he says, I will not be able to work, which means I will not be able to pay for the rent. That means that I will not be able to, my life will get completely hectic. It will stop. And he says, I was worrying and worrying and worrying, and I was flapping with my wings, and I was praying but worrying about it. And then one day I realized, there is nothing I can do. I've made a mistake. I've repented. I believe God set me free from drinking. I haven't drank since. I go to morning prayers. I serve God, and I'm gonna give this to God and say, God, you have a problem. And your problem, God, is your license is about to be taken away. I am not gonna worry about it because this is too big for me to handle. I'm gonna go to sleep and I'm gonna let you worry about it because this is your size problem. I'm very tiny, big problem, tiny man. You big God, big problem. I'm pretty sure you can handle it. He says, that's exactly what he said. And he says, Vlad, I gave it to God. You know, these words is a cliche, but to him, it was life and death. To him, it was a sleeping night where he says, I slept like a baby, knowing next morning, I'm gonna receive a letter. For 6 months to a year, I don't have a license. He says, and next, the week after that, he says, I received a letter from drive licensing for no reason. They simply notified me that my license will not be suspended or will not be taken. With tears rolling down his eyes, he said, this was the first month I was able to pay for my rent, pay my mama's rent, my sister's rent, pay my tithes, and have a little bit of extra. When you spread your wings when the storm comes, I don't know how it happens, but you always go higher. If you flap it, it will snap and break your wings. If you hide from the storm, if you run to the club, if you go into a pornography to ease that stress, if you pick up a bottle and simply say, I just need to numb that. Listen, you are living like a chicken, but when you are an eagle, you shouldn't do that. You can do better because you can go higher. I want us to pray right now for this coming year, for the faith we have, that God will let us use it. I want you to rise to your feet. Place your hand upon your heart. Close your eyes, and I want you to pray that this coming year, God will teach you to overcome problems. For problems not to define you. For problems, the challenge is for you not to run, but for you to overcome and for you to spread your wings. Spread your wings. To spread your wings. Don't hide, but spread. Learn to trust, not just strive. Not just try harder, but trust more. To surrender more. Not strive, but surrender more. Open up your lips. Close your eyes. Begin to ask God right now for that grace.
Yes, Father God, this evening, God, we ask you, God, help us, God, to face, God, our storms, God. Help us, God, to spread our wings, God. Winds of faith, God. We want to go higher, God. We want to overcome every storm, God, that we'll face, God, in 2016, God. We don't want to be like chickens running away, God, but we want to trust you, God. We don't know how, God, or we don't know when, God, but we trust you with our faith. We spread our faith, God. We say, God, take us higher, God. Help us to overcome, God, every addiction, every problem, every sickness, God, every money struggles, God. We trust you, God. We refuse to, God, to live in fear, God. We step, God, in 2016 saying, God, that we'll trust in you, God, with our faith, God, spread wide, God. Holy Spirit, take us higher, God. Help us to overcome every storm in the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
I'm going to declare that over your life, that every problem that comes in your way is not going to kill you. It will only promote you. I want you to open up your lips, stretch your hands right now to heaven and begin to declare that every problem that comes my way, my Bible makes me to understand that those who love God and are called according to His purpose, everything will work for their good. Not everything will be good, but everything will work for your good because you spread your wings. Because though He slay me, I will trust Him. Because like Job, you will lay at your face before God and say, God, I will worship you. God, I will trust you. God, you didn't fall from your throne. God, when my finances are running dry, God, when I'm only getting F's because I cannot understand the subject in school, I still trust you. You're the one that gives wisdom. You're the one that gives power. You're the one that restores marriages. You're the one that gives love where there is no love. God, I trust you. Lift your hands right now. Begin to say, God, these problems will promote me. These problems will not kill me. These problems will not sabotage me. These problems will not end my life. These problems will not define me. These problems will not leave me like my parents maybe were left, like my friends were left. I will be elevated. I will be promoted. I will rise higher. I will overcome. I will spread my wings. I will spread my wings. I will spread my wings. I will trust in God. I will trust in God. In Jesus' mighty name. In Jesus' mighty name. In Jesus' mighty name. Say, every storm will come to an end. Say, every problem will not kill me, but promote me. Said that Goliath will make me famous. In Jesus' name. Take your seat for just a few moments. The third thing is that eagles, they live above ground. Eagles, they live above ground. If I can ask everybody's attention, including Marvin's, not to walk around, but just take your seats until I'm done. This is your moment where God wants to deposit something into your heart. And so I want everyone to just be respectful. Unless you need to leave, then yes. But otherwise, please hang in there. Eagles, they live above the ground. Unlike chickens that live in the barn. Unlike those little birds that can either speak gospel verses or curse words in your house. They get trained parrots. Eagles, they live and they have their residence very high in the sky where most of the predators cannot arrive and cannot climb to. Where your physical body lives is your address. That's where your physical body lives. But your mind lives in the other address. Your attitude is the address of your mind. Your attitude is the address of your mind. You can physically live in the richest neighborhood in Tri-Cities and mentally live in a ghetto. You can physically live in 99301, physically, but mentally be homeless because the thoughts that constantly come out of you are shame, guilt, depression, discouragement, anxiety. You're working at the prestigious job, except anxiety comes in mentally, the attitude. You have those moments where you kind of fly and you have those good days. Somebody gives you a free coffee. Somebody gives you a little promotion, gives you a nice words. You know, your spouse or your children or your parents give you a little moment of attention and you go out and you fly so good. But then when the day is over, you go back to your home. Your attitude place. And as a home for the body is your address, the home for the mind is your attitude. Your attitude. And many times for us, what happens is that we go through things in life and we become hurt. We go through things in life and we become devastated inside, or we pick up certain demons, we become certain depression, certain anxiety, and it becomes our home. We come to church, we feel good for 2 hours, and we go back home to an attitude of defeat, attitude of rebellion, attitude of discouragement, attitude of depression, attitude of I am not good, my life has no point, everybody's advancing, nobody loves me, nobody pays attention to me, and it's your nest. It's called a barn life. You can't be an eagle and live in a barn. My mission today is to burn your barn. Burn the barn. Mental address has to be burned. If it's not high, I can't fly high if I live low. I can't reach high if at my low points I always come back to a low place in the barn. I must, as a person, and you have to be, the first place you must change is not the zip code for your house, it's the zip code for your mind, it's your attitude. Your attitude has to be a winning attitude. That's why word attitude and altitude sound the same, and they're actually about the same in your spiritual life. The altitude in life is actually your attitude in life. You can't have a positive attitude and live a negative life for very long. But you also cannot have a positive life and have a negative attitude for very long. God wants to change your address today. Last year, right at this moment, 2 more hours, a little bit before, I moved from Richland to Pasco. It took a while to move. We transitioned. I had to change my address. The mail still goes to Richland sometimes. There was a transition that I had to take. I live so much closer to church now. I can walk to church. And I love living in Pasco. Not for the Pasco's sake, but because it's closer to church. It's closer to my wife's work. When I went to my brother's house for lunch a few Sundays ago, I felt like I went to Seattle. I drove to Richland. I was like, when am I going to get to that Richland? It's 15 minutes. And I told him, I'm not coming again. This is too hard, too long. Because I'm used to 25 seconds to 30 seconds distance because I live closer. As I was meditating on that before the service, I saw the picture of how you can live close mentally to God. Where mentally you make an address for your attitude. I am a victor, not a victim. You're closer to God. When you make a decision, I am not a sick person trying to get healthy. I'm a healthy person fighting sickness. You get 20 seconds between you and God. Compared to 3 hours, compared to 15 minutes. When you make a decision, I am not broke, poor, always struggling, but I am a blessed person because I have an El Shaddai. I have a Jehovah Rapha. I have a Jehovah Ra. I have a God who provides for me. Not my boss. He is the resource. My God is the source. But I'm currently struggling, but my God will meet all of my needs according to my riches and your glory. That is your mental address. With that mental address, you're closer to God. God wants us to change. Not where we fly, where we live. When all the flying is done, where do you rest? When the service is done, the hype is down, the speaker is no longer with the microphone, pastor doesn't challenge, music doesn't inspire, you go back home on the pillow and you turn on your lamp and you smell the carpet and everything. You come into your house, you pick up the bills. Where does your mind find its rest? Is it in the barn or on the rocks? Because you're an eagle, you're not a chicken. You're not a chicken. You may say my friends are depressed. Well, you're not your friends. The creator of universe is your daddy. Real nature, a majestic, a powerful, fearless, majestic nature lives inside of you. You say you don't know my mama. Well, I'm telling you about your daddy. You say, well, you don't know what I grew up in. Well, I'm telling you where you should be living in now. Don't live in a rich neighborhood, but your mind being in the ghetto. Graduate, move your mind, pack your bags, burn the barn, and come to a place where saying, you know what? I may be broke in my pocket, but I'm not broke in my mind. I may be sick in my body, but I'm not sick in my heart. I may feel discouraged in my emotions, but listen, I am not discouraged in my mind. I am seated in the heavenly places with Christ Jesus. I will think on high things where Jesus dwells, and Jesus is not in the valley. Valley is what I go through, it's not where I camp. And that is about you and that is about me. Can somebody say amen? I want us to right now in this place, this is not just gonna be prayer, but in this prayer to break down mental barns. Depression has to end before 12 o'clock. You no longer have to sit at work and cry. You no longer have to be at home and weep for no reason. That spirit of depression is a barn where the devil has kept you and lied to you and said, you're a chicken. Well, I have a news for you today. We brought some flashlight and we brought some fire to burn that barn and to tell you're not a chicken and that's not where you belong. You've been there, but you belong somewhere else. Rise to your feet. I want you to place your hand on your mind. And I want you to right now begin to burn. Say, Holy Spirit, through your word. Say this with me. Say, Holy Spirit, I receive. I'm not a chicken. I receive. I don't live in a barn. I live in your word. I live high where you live. I defeat every suicidal thought. Every depression. You have to die in Jesus' name. Every anxiety, guilt and shame, you have no place in my mind. I come against you in Jesus' name. Come on right now, begin to rebuke every depression, every suicidal thought. If the devil has lied to you, said you're ugly, worthless, you're poor, broke, sick, nothing ever works for you, I want you to begin to burn that right now. You're not a chicken stuck, you are an eagle. Begin to burn those lies where the devil says nobody ever loved you, you had no daddy, you had no mama. Say, devil, you're a liar. I have a father who rules the world. I have a daddy who loves me unconditionally. You are a liar. I burn that barn right now. I burn that lie right now. In Jesus' mighty name,
we come against every lie of Satan. We come against every fear. We come against every anxiety in Jesus' mighty name. Be broken in Jesus' name. We come against every anxiety. We come against every nightmare in Jesus' mighty name. Be removed in Jesus' name. We come against you. We elevate this evening. We elevate our mind. We take our mind higher. We come out from depression, from anxiety, from fear, from shame. We choose to live in the mountains. We choose to live in a high altitude with a high attitude in Jesus' mighty name. Lord, we choose to accept your word as a refuge, as a rock, as a mountain or where we would dwell, God, where we spend our time, where we live, God. Your word will be the standard for our lives. Your word will be a standard, God, for what you have for us in 2016, God. We choose to leave behind the past. We choose to leave behind the hurts. We choose to leave for behind every unforgiveness. Forgiveness, every resentment. God, today we make a choice, God, to follow you and to elevate to where you are calling us in Jesus' mighty name.
This barn thing is not a joke. In high school, they give equivalent medicine that is given to kids who struggle with depression is equivalent to the same medicine that was given to people in asylum, in mental institutions 20 years ago. Today, that is a chronic problem in our generation, and it's the devil and demons that are behind it. Even people in this room, that sometimes when the enemy, you know, to me, this is just an emotional, but when you talk to people, you see how deeply Satan captivates and destroys their life through that depression and through that spirit. Place your hand on your mind right now, and I'm going to rebuke every depression. You have to walk out of this place. different. If you have suicidal thoughts, suicidal tendencies, you're hearing voices right now, this is your day. The barn is burning. The barn is burning. Every suicidal thought, in the name of Jesus Christ, I command it to die. I command it right now. You have no place in the life of an eagle. Your house is being vacant. I command you to leave in Jesus' mighty name. Every depression that is generational, every anxiety that is demonic, in Jesus' mighty name, loose your grip in Jesus' mighty name, loose your grip in Jesus' mighty name, loose your grip out of God's people, out of their mind. They will not live in fear, they will not live in phobia, they will not live in depression, they will not live in anxiety, they will not live in confusion, they will not live in the clouded mind. In Jesus' mighty name, Satan, get your nasty hands out of their minds, out of their lives, in Jesus' mighty name. Loose those people in Jesus' mighty name. Loose those people in Jesus' mighty name. Loose that young girl. Loose that young man. Loose that father. Loose that mother. Loose that young little infant in Jesus' mighty name. That crying that doesn't stop. Those nightmares and those phobias, they stop today in Jesus' mighty name. They stop today in Jesus' mighty name. If you are watching this service right now, a spirit of depression that has a grip over your life, the Holy Spirit wants to touch you right now where you are at right now and loose you from there, and loose you from there, and loose you from there in Jesus' mighty name. Let freedom come right now. My location is not in my past, but in the promise of God. Say, I belong to the promise of God. Say, my address, my attitude, my mindset is in the promise of God, not the problems of life. In Jesus' name. Sit down for just a moment. Let me skip a few. I'm going to continue to pray. Eagles' diet. Eagles have a very unique diet. They don't eat the same things that vultures eat. When vultures eat of dead things, eagles eat of fresh, particularly fish. And because they have a very good and a unique diet, they have this capacity to be able to fly on a very high altitudes. I want us to remember something right now, and we're going to pray again, is that in order for you to fly high, you have to eat right. When you eat like a chicken, you can fly like an eagle. When you eat like a chicken, you can fly like an eagle. If everything that is out there that's on Netflix, if everything that's out there that is new on iTunes, if everything out there today, and you begin to feed yourself with that, next thing that happens is you can soar high. I want you guys to pay attention. Here. This year, for you to have courage and strength, you have to choose your diet. Choose what you allow to come inside of you. Choose what you feed yourself with. Choose the information, the movies, the music and everything. Choose it properly, because that determines how high you will go in your life. Without that, you cannot go very high in life. And there's many other aspects that we're not going to touch on right now concerning eagles. It might maybe one day that we will do. But Adam, he was like that eagle. He was called by God to fulfill the mission on this earth. But one of the requirements that God gave to Adam is that, Adam, you have to watch what you eat. There are certain things, certain tree, you got to stay away from it. It's there, but you can't eat it. And we know when Adam ate of that tree, next thing that happened is his wings felt weak. He no longer could be everything God called him to be. On the opposite, he started to hide. Instead of soaring, going to God, he started to run from God. He lived in shame. He blamed his wife. And the two kids that were there, one killed another. A mess started on this earth. God wants you to live a life where you choose your diet carefully. Those of you who go and work out, you know one thing about exercise. If you exercise in the gym and eat donuts and drink pop, your exercise almost is pointless. Exercise has to be filled with a proper diet. Same thing is with church attendance. Church attendance is like exercise. It's very important. When you put in your tithes to God, extremely important. When you show up to morning prayer, that is amazing. That is like doing a cardio for your heart. But if the moment you leave, and the kind of music that's playing, the kind of movies that are watched, you have to understand, you are poisoning your own soul. And then there is no confidence. If you sit on a couch and watch Netflix for 3 hours, I'm going to tell you of one thing. You won't be going to the gym. You won't be doing your homework. You won't be reading your Bible. If you sit in front of a computer and you play a video game for 3 or 4 hours, after that, next morning, you won't be at the morning prayer. You won't have no motivation. You will cancel the home group. You will say, well, nobody's coming. You didn't even try to reach out to them. Why? Because a diet determines your fuel. It determines your passion. When I see people saying, I lack passion, I always ask them the first thing. Tell me what you listen to, what you read, and what are you watching? It's not magic. It's not a secret. It's just what you eat is who you are. If you lack passion, it's because of what you're eating. If same thing physically, you know, when we begin to go out of shape, it's not because we don't exercise, and some of our jobs are more in the cubicle or behind the car or everything, but it's also a lot of it is what we are partaking. An average CEO reads 4 to 5 books every single month. An average person in America reads 1 book a year, and 60% of them only read first chapter. Now make the difference. An eagle eats different than a person who is not as successful. Now I'm not saying being a CEO is the highest definition of success, but I'm using as an example that somehow these guys eat differently. They live different, they reach different heights. And the people who simply say, well, I'm not wired to read. Vlad, I can't read. And that's 60% of doing one chapter, that's me. Started the fourth dimension, got through the first introduction, and I'm stuck there. Or Genesis chapter 1. Well, this year, things have to change. Read more, watch less movies. Listen to more podcasts, less music. Begin to feed yourself more. Don't just feed yourself with things that, well, it doesn't have cuss words. Well, you know what? I go to those concerts, but I don't do those bad things. I know they're not Christian, but I just like the beat. It's just the beat that moves me. I have a dog that lives on the outside, and we let her in, come in sometimes for emotional bonding in our family. And when the dog comes in, the first thing that dog goes to is a toilet. And no, she doesn't go to the toilet for the same reasons I go to the toilet. She goes to the toilet to drink water. Oh, and she drinks that water passionately. drinks it, and I'm standing there, and I was like, oh my goodness, if you would ever know whatever went to the toilet. You know, in her world, the water is clean. She has made it to herself. This water is clean. It looks clean. I'm looking at that, and I said, this water is not clean, but it's a dog. That's why it can do that. And many times, that's exactly what we do as Christians, is we look at things, we're like, well, there's nothing wrong with that. And God looks at that and says, well, there's bacteria in it. And this is the excuse we make. Well, I am going to drink it and push away the bacteria. I'm going to watch the movie. I'm just going to skip the sex scenes. I know it has 175 F words. I'm going to bleep them out as I'm going to watch 175 F words. Really? That's like saying, I'm going to drink a toilet water and bleep out the bacteria. That's not going to happen. This year, if you want to change your life, change your diet. Change what you read. Change what you watch. Change what you read. And if your pride is that you read Twilight this year and that's your accomplishment, I'm not talking about Twilight. I'm talking about reading some other light that actually gives you light, not deception. Reading things that will actually benefit you. If your accomplishment this year is finally finishing the 50 Shades of Stupid or 50 Shades of Grey, that's not the accomplishment. I want you to read things that we recommend to read about Holy Spirit, about success, about things that elevate you, not bring you down. Become a reader this year. Become a person who fills your life with a proper diet. In Jesus' name, amen. And your life will be successful. Amen. I want you to rise to your feet. The last thing that the eagle does is the eagle renews its feathers. They say that every year or every few years, an eagle goes through a process where the feathers are removed. And the eagle feels very vulnerable. And then the new feathers grow and the eagle becomes stronger and stronger. The Bible says those who wait upon the Lord, they renew their strength. They renew their strength. I want us to pray for this year that God will renew our passion for His kingdom. That this year, passion for God will be renewed. And I'm going to ask each one of you, if you want that for your life, if you say, Vlad, I want my passion for God be renewed. Even if you have a great passion, I want it to be renewed for God. I want you to come to the front, which means all of us. Let's come to the front right now. We still have the party. It's going to happen in just a few minutes. But I want you to come to the front and we are going to pray. God, renew my passion. God, renew my zeal for your kingdom. God, renew my zeal for your will, for doing home groups, for doing evangelism, for giving in Jesus' mighty name. As you've come, and let's come closer. Let's fill all the front in Jesus' name. You can close your eyes. Begin to right now cry out to God. Say, Holy Spirit, renew my life. Restore my soul. Holy Spirit, fill me with freshness in Jesus'
mighty
name.
Yes, Father, we ask you, Lord, that you begin to renew our passion, Lord. Begin to renew our determination, our desire for you, Lord. That we'll be, Father, passionate. We'll be committed, Lord. We'll be loyal to your word, Father. We'll be loyal to spending time with you, to walking with you, Lord. To be able to understand your voice. To be able to hear your voice, Father. We ask you, Lord, that you renew our passion, you renew our fire, Lord, for you, that this will not just be a thing that happens and then disappears, Lord, but there'll be commitment, Lord, that there'll be loyalty, Lord, that there'll be hard work put into it, Lord, knowing that Jesus, spending time with you is the best time we can spend, it's the best time we can invest into ourselves, knowing that, Lord, that anything that comes in contact with you, Lord, becomes productive, becomes to be blessed, delivered, and saved, Lord Jesus. We ask you, renew our passion for you, Lord. Renew our fire, that we are walking with you, Lord, on a daily basis, that we be able to understand your voice, hear with you, walk with you, Lord Jesus. In the name of Jesus,
renew my passion. Just say, Holy Spirit, lift your hands right now to God. If you say, God, I want to renew my passion, say, Holy Spirit, renew my passion to seek your face every morning. Renew my passion to love people who don't know Jesus. Say, Holy Spirit, I choose your diet, your information, your material in my life in Jesus' name. Come on, begin to pray right now for your diet. Begin to pray right now that this year will be the year where you're going to begin to feed yourself. Close your eyes and say, God, the Holy Spirit is convicting some of you of the things that you've been watching that you need to stop doing, that the things that you've been partaking, that today you're going to have to cleanse your life. You got to put that spiritual pop aside. You got to put that thing, spiritual donuts aside and simply feed yourself with information that will give you success. Say, Holy Spirit, give me that in Jesus' mighty name.
Holy Spirit, we ask you in Jesus' mighty name that this year, 2016, will be a year, God, when we will get spiritually fit, God, when we will begin to fill our soul, fill our mind, fill our heart with your word, with your promises, that we, God, that you will give us a spirit of revelation, God, that this year, God, we will go deeper in your word, Lord. If we never read the Bible, God, that we will finish, God, reading the Bible this year. We'll read the New Testament, God, this year. I pray, God, that this year, Lord, we commit ourselves to the reading of your word, that we will commit ourselves of seeking you in the morning, God, seeking you at night, God, that our life will be spent, God, with you this year, Lord, going deeper, God. I ask you, help us to put away, God, every sin, God, everything that, God, ensnares us easily, God, that brings a passion down, God, everything, God, that stops us from pursuing you, God, pursuing your call and your purpose for our life, Lord. We ask you, Lord, that this year will be a year, God, of a strict diet, God, of how we feed ourselves spiritually, God, how we feed ourselves emotionally, God, and spiritually, in Jesus' mighty name, Lord, that we will fill ourselves with the right kind of podcasts, God, right kind of information, right kind of boost, God. Give us the desire and discipline in Jesus' mighty name.
In Jesus' name, right now we are going to pray that God will renew your health. I want us to pray specifically the skin. Problem with skin, that God will renew the skin. It will be, the Bible says, youth renewed like the youth. That means that those of you who have problem with skin, I really have just a strong thing in my heart before the service that I started to pray for that. And we're going to pray for right now any skin problems, that God will renew your skin like the skin of the youth, especially if you are a young person. If you have a problem with the heart, or you have a problem with other organs in your body, that God will renew. God is able, through His angels, give you a surgery and give you a brand new heart. brand new lungs, a brand new kidneys. It can give just brand new blood that is flowing through your body. So right now, place your hand any place where there is a need of renewal in your physical body right now, and we are going to pray the Holy Spirit will renew in Jesus' mighty name. In the area of skin, I speak right now God's renewal in Jesus' mighty name. Every sickness that has to do with skin, every sickness that has to do with eyes, every sickness that has to do even with the hair, in the name of Jesus Christ, let God's renewal come, not this year but right now. Let God, through the Holy Spirit, God's angels, bring right now renewal. Let your skin be renewed in Jesus' mighty name. Let your blood vessels be renewed in Jesus' mighty name. Let your bones be strengthened in Jesus' mighty name. Let your nerves be renewed right now. Let them be fixed right now in Jesus' mighty name. All the kidney, in the name of Jesus, let your kidneys be renewed due to smoking, kidney stones, let those be flushed out in Jesus' mighty name. In Jesus' mighty name, every irregular heartbeat, let it be renewed. Let the heart be renewed right now in the name of Jesus Christ. Place your hand upon a sick part of your body and right now open up your lips and begin to declare, this is the year your body, your appearance, you will feel younger. You will look younger because you're an eagle and you're going through a renewal. Let's pray.
Yes, Father, we ask you, Lord Jesus, for the renewal of our body, Lord, that you made us as a whole, Father. You made us complete. Lord, you made us without pain. You made us without infirmities or disease. And Lord, we ask you that this upcoming year, Lord, there will be a restoration. Lord, that there will be a healing, Father, in our mind, Lord, that we do not think that we're always sick, Lord. That in my mind, we don't think that we are defeated and that God, you're punishing us, Lord. But we know that, Jesus, that you will renew our lives, Lord, like the eagles, Lord. That our skin is different, Lord. Our mind is different. Our blood is different, Lord. Our strength in our bones and our muscles, Lord. That we'll be able to live healthy, Lord. They'll be able to know that our body is your temple, Lord. That through our body we give you glory, Lord Jesus. That we're made in the image and likeness of you, Lord Jesus. And you do not hold sickness. You do not hold disease, Lord. We ask you for restoration, Lord. We ask you for healing in Jesus' mighty name.
In Jesus' mighty name, let backs be renewed. Everywhere where there is pain in the back or in the knees, in the name of Jesus Christ, renewal of God, let it come right now. Sugar levels, let them be restored right now. High blood pressure and sugar diabetes, in the name of Jesus Christ, let it be gone right now. And let renewal come into your health right now, in the name of Jesus Christ. Fatigue, in Jesus' mighty name, let God's restoration come into your body. Come into your body this year, in Jesus' mighty name. I want us to pray right now for the renewal in our finances. Now, those of you who are in high school, that you pray for your finances as well. But those of you who are in college and out of college, especially for finances, no problems with jobs. If you have your phone or your wallet on you, I want you to take it out and I want you to place it in your hand. If you're a businessman or if you're working at the job, most likely you will receive the notification that you got a job, or most likely any good or bad news, you receive it through your phone. Anybody has a phone on them? If you have a phone on you, I want you to hold your phone like this. This is the source through which good news or bad news could come through. And right now we are going to pray, God, that this year my finances and the area of finances in my life will be renewed, and that this will only give me good news. I will get jobs, I will get blessings, and that wonderful man of God that I've been texting, he will finally reply in Jesus' name. Or stop replying. Whichever is more a blessing in Jesus' name, amen. That this will become, I know how a phone can be a blessing. When I see my renters calling, my heart skips a beat, not out of the excitement. And then I know sometimes you get a text message and somebody says, hey, what is your address? Because God told me to send you $1,000. Or, you know, hey, what like Tony, they say, hey, pastor, are you home right now? Are you awake? And I said, yes, what's going on? Are you in trouble? No, my mom made tamales. I just need to drop tamales at your house. I said, yes, I am fully awake. Bring them on. And by the way, those tamales were amazing. Still eating them. Phone is a place of good news or bad news. Your phone is a place for good news. You're standing in the sanctuary of a good news church. renew right now. Say, God, renew your miracles in my life. Renew financial breakthrough in my life. Raise your phone if you have it, or your wallet. Begin to say, this is a source of good news in my life. I will receive only good news. No stalkers, no naysayers, gossipers, whiners. None of that stuff is going to be. No trauma is going to fall on my life. God, this year, I'm going to receive a good news in Jesus'
mighty name. Yes, Father God, we prophesy, God, next year, God, 2006 will be a year, God, full of good news. God, we'll begin, God, with good news, God, in the mighty name of Jesus. When it comes to our money, God, when it comes to our job, God, you will prosper us, God. We will have more than enough, and we shall not lack, God. We'll give, God, from our abundance, God. We ask you, God, bless our jobs, God. Give us promotion, God. Take us higher, God. I ask you, God, give raises, God. Help us, God, to prosper, God, so we can be blessing, God, in the mighty name of Jesus, God. That our phones, God, will be a source, God, of good news, God. We reject, God, every failure, God, every bankruptcy, God. We speak your blessing, God. Help us to prosper, God, from inside out, God. We bless our money, God. We bless our job, God. We bless our economy, God. We bless our city, God. Help us to prosper, God, so we can bless, God. Give to us so you can give through us, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Come on, say it with me. Say, in 2016, say, I disconnect myself from every limitation. Say, I disconnect myself from every setback. Say, I disconnect myself from poverty. Say, I declare provision of God. Say, I declare promotions. Say, I declare bonuses. Say, I declare the job of my career in Jesus' name. Come on, begin to prophesy and declare into 2016. Begin to declare God's promises. Begin to disconnect yourself from every setback. Begin to disconnect yourself from every failure. Begin to disconnect yourself from every curse of poverty. Begin to speak the blessings of God over your life. Blessings of God over career. Begin to speak blessings of God over your finances in Jesus' mighty name. Begin to declare the promises of God over your business in Jesus' mighty name. Begin to declare that God is your provider, and He will provide for every need, and He will fulfill every desire of your heart in 2016. Then 2016 will be the year of reward in Jesus' mighty name. 2016 will be a year where you will step into your destiny. 2016 will be a year where you will finally pay off your debt, that the generational curse of poverty will be broken over your life, that 2016 will be a year of breakthrough in Jesus' mighty name.
In Jesus' mighty name we pray. I want you to close your eyes and bow your head, and I'm just going to give an opportunity to anyone here who needs to give his life to Jesus, who maybe needs to reconnect or renew your relationship with God. Every year in the Gold's Gym, I renew my membership. With the Charter Internet, I renew my membership. Maybe you have fallen off the wagon. Maybe you walked away from the Lord. Maybe you grew up religious, but you have never really made a decision to make Jesus your Lord. Your parents baptized you when you were an infant, but now it's your choice to make Jesus your Lord. And this is a perfect opportunity. If there was no better day, today is that better day than to begin a new year in a new relationship, having a master, Jesus Christ. He's the best master because He loves you unconditionally. He wants to forgive you of your sin and write you your name in His book of life, so you will go to heaven, but most importantly, so He can bring heaven step by step into your life. If you're that person who's a pastor, Vlad, it's me. I want to begin my year right. I want to give my life to Jesus Christ. I want you to raise your hand if you're that person, and I'm going to pray with you. This is your day. This is your night, and this is perfect opportunity to do that today. This is your moment. Give your life to Jesus. If the Lord is leading you today, if the Lord is calling you, respond to His call. Respond to His call. You may say, well, I still can do other time. My friend, you don't know what the other time holds. If the Lord is leading you, give your life to Jesus today. Surrender your life. Just slip up your hand. Don't. Who cares what anybody thinks? People are not thinking anything. We are happy when we see people making the decision to serve Jesus. Happy to see people give their lives to Jesus Christ. Anybody else? Anybody else who's saying, you know, Vlad, this is my day. This is my night. This is my year. I need to give my life to Jesus. Thank you. Anybody else? I'm just going to wait for a few more seconds. I know that this is the day. This is the perfect opportunity that you must take to surrender your life to the Lord Jesus Christ. I'm going to wait for a few more seconds because God wants you to go into this year a brand new person. God wants you to go into this year a changed person. And that change doesn't start from quitting drinking. It starts from quitting living for yourself and saying, God, I surrender. God, I give my heart to you. God, I live for you. In Jesus' mighty name. In Jesus' mighty name. Holy Spirit, I ask you right now that you will move mightily, that you will touch every heart, every soul right now that wants to take that step toward you. Every soul that right now wants to take that step toward you. Lord God, that you will begin to do something special in their heart, in their life, that you will renew those who've lost that relationship, that you will renew that in Jesus' mighty name. I want us, we're going to take just a moment and pray for these people specifically. If you had your hand, if you can just quietly come, don't make too much space. If you can quietly come, a gentleman from the back, Paul and the lady from the back, just come over here. We're going to pray. And I'm going to ask again, if you need to recommit your life, maybe you always walked with God, but you recognize that you just fell off the wagon. Your relationship with God has been, you say, you know, publicly, I just need to take this step. Come. You just come. There's no shame in anything. Whatever your statue is, whatever your position is, it's about you and God. And that's what really it's all about today. And so you take the step today. Let God help you. Throw away your pride. Take the step with God, and God will give you the courage and the strength today in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Amen. Let's pray, church, together. We're just going to stretch your hands right now. Let's support them in prayer right now. Cover them with prayer right now in the name of Jesus Christ. Let's pray for the Father in the name of Jesus Christ. We ask you that you're going to begin to touch their lives right now in Jesus' mighty name. Holy Spirit, that you will begin to bring support, that you will begin to bring change in Jesus' mighty name, that you will begin to bring right now a new life. Anywhere, God, where the enemy has stolen, restore sevenfold, Father, in the name of Jesus. Father, we pray right now, God, any place where there is maybe addiction, any place where the enemy has had a hold, God, it's right now that there will be freedom in Jesus' mighty name, God. We pray in the name of Jesus, any place where there has been pain, any place where there has been rejection, any words that would have been spoken from the enemy or generational curses, right now, we break it in Jesus' mighty name. We break it in Jesus' mighty name. Holy Spirit, we ask you that you will right now infuse with strength, that your grace will come where there is weakness, and you will begin to give them the power to do what they couldn't do before, the power to do what they were able not to do before, God, that their life begins to change from the inside out in Jesus' mighty name. Heal from any abuse, God. Heal from any hurt. Remove every shame. Remove every shame. Remove every guilt in Jesus' mighty name. Oh, Holy Spirit, we ask you for your blood of Jesus right now to break every chain, the blood of Jesus to shift things in the spiritual world in Jesus' mighty name, in the name of Jesus Christ. Let's just pray a simple prayer with them, church. Let's just pray this prayer. Say, Lord Jesus, I come to you in need of help. Your word says you give grace to the humble. I humble myself before you. Give me your grace. Let your blood wash my sin. Wash the guilt of sin, the shame, condemnation, despair, depression. Break every curse over my life. Heal every wound. I break every word spoken against me. Let it be broken in Jesus' name. My future is blessed because of Jesus. In Jesus' name, amen.